Few moments in the Olympic pageant compare in sheer grace under pressure to the solitary diver poised high above the fray. A study of complete concentration and singleness of mind, uninterrupted even through the quick, breathtaking hurtle through space toward the pool below. It's both a leap of faith and of consummate skill. And during these games, this sport is likely to scale heights greater than ever before. Tonight, our diving coverage continues with the final of the women's platform. The favorites include Elena Moroshina of the Soviet Union. A workmanlike job in the preliminaries, we should see more spark today. Qin Xiaodan of China. She has high degree of difficulty in her dives. If she hits, she will win the gold. Xu Yanmei of China. Possibly the most consistent diver here, but she has a low degree of difficulty that may keep her out of the medal. From the United States, Michelle Mitchell, strong medal possibilities. Wendy Lian Williams, her first Olympics, still the unknown. Welcome to the Chomshul Indoor Swimming Pool. This is the diving venue, and the feeling today is entirely different than it was yesterday, because today we have the finals of the women's 10-meter platform. I'm Charlie Jones. This is former Olympic diving coach Steve McFarland. You can feel the tension in the air. Who's your favorite?
You certainly can. My favorite, Elena Moroshina from the Soviet Union.
You've stayed with her. Why?
I think the pressure is off her. She didn't dive that well in the preliminaries. I know she's got good dives in her, and I think we'll see them today.
My pick is Qin Xiaodan of China. Her degree of difficulties, the list is so high that she can miss a couple as long as she just hits a couple and still wins.
I think her degree of difficulty is very impressive, but I also believe she will be erratic. And in this contest, that's not going to help.
What about the United States? A chance to medal.
Wendy Lian Williams, a newcomer really to the international scene, and we just don't know how she'll do here. But it comes down to two dives for her, back 2½ somersault and reverse 2½ somersault.
And what about Michelle?
Michelle Mitchell, she knows what this is, her last event, and she wants to end on a good note. I think we could see a medal from Michelle Mitchell here.
She's retiring after today's competition. 10 meters, almost 33 feet, you could say three stories high. How do you relate to that? Well, let's see it through the eye of a diver.
And here we have our diver doing the inward 1½ somersault, poised on the end of the platform, getting the feet ready, putting the arms over the head, feeling the ankles start to quiver, and now the throw for the somersault. There's the water, here it comes, the lineup, and the entry is there.
Now that's in slow motion. What is it like at real speed?
At real speed, Charlie, it's the blink of an eye. Watch.
Thank you, Dick. After the four rounds here of the compulsories in the finals, Michelle Mitchell of the United States, interestingly enough, is in first place. Xu Yanmei of China is in second. Stasilevich of the Soviet Union is in third. Qin Xiaodan of China is in fourth. And those figure right now, the way everybody is diving, that they are the four, as you can look down through the 12 who have made the finals, that the medals could well be decided amongst.
And it's very surprising to see Michelle, who thought she would be anywhere from 5 to 10 points behind the Soviets and the Chinese going into the first round of optionals. And here she is, the leader.
And in the compulsory, she has one dive that she has to hit, and she hit it.
And we see Michelle here in the hot tub getting that hot water over her so she relaxes her muscles, especially her arms. It's very important to have those arms nice and loose.
This was a moment ago.
This is her inward dive pike. This is the final dive in her first four in the compulsories. And look at that. What an entry. She's just really on today.
And she has been on with every dive. She has been on with eights, eights and a half, sevens and a half. That is the story here. And we will, of course, continue to follow Michelle Mitchell when she comes up in the rotation. Right now, let's go back to gymnastics. Thank you, Dick. We're at the Chomshul Indoor Swimming Pool. This is Charlie Jones and Steve McFarland. Right now, we are in the fifth round of the finals. And the diving has not been as sharp as we thought it would be, and the judging has not been as high as we thought it would be. They probably go hand in hand.
They certainly do. Sometimes, and in this case, they are going hand in hand. The divers are just not as sharp as we would expect, but in a way, That's helped Michelle because she is really on today.
All right, here's Angela Stasilevich of the Soviet Union. She is in third place after the fourth round. Again, we're in the fifth round. Coach is looking on.
This is her inward 2 1/2 somersault pike, 2.8. And is this a good dive? She really did a fine one in the preliminaries.
And through the first four rounds, though, she has been sliding. Started first, then second, then fourth, now in third.
She, too, is just a little off the pace. You see her coach there. She says, okay, but we all know she could have done it better. What was, if you could say anything negative about this dive, it was that she didn't get her body perfectly straight to simply disappear for that rip entry. See how her hips are just a little late getting there, a little late stretching to the water.
7.5, 7's a total of 62-16. Angela Stasilevich of the Soviet Union. And here is Wendy Leanne Williams of the United States. She started in 12th place. That is last. There are 12 competitors. That is her sister capturing this for the photo album. Right now, she is in 6th place.
And this is normally a very good dive for her. A back 1 1/2 somersault, 2 1/2 twists, 2.8 degree of difficulty.
Crowd like it.
The crowd like it, and I liked it too, Charlie. That will really
Wendy
help.
Wendy Leanne likes it too, and her sister did. It's unanimous. Eights?
Eights, I would guess eights on this. The judges have been a little stingy today. Let's see how she does from the overhead. See how she wraps that twist. Now you get a real feel for that nice drop to the water. Lined up very well. This is Scott Rich, her coach, and certainly he likes it too.
There are 7 judges here, and none of the judges are from any of the countries that are represented with the final 12 divers. They have 7 scores. There's 3 on the far side and 4 judges on the near side. The relationship that they have to the platform. You throw out the high and the low. You take add the other scores times degree of difficulty times 60%. So you can compare that if you have a 5-judge panel, and that is the score that you have. Here's Xu Yanmei of China.
She's doing the inward 2 1/2 somersault pike, 2.8.
And she is in 2nd place.
Xu Yanmei, defending World Cup champion. This is the assistant coach for the Chinese. And they're a little concerned because they expected their divers to be diving better. This dive, however, is superb. Look at that pike position. The only flaw I saw was as she passed the tower, feet went slightly flat. She got it back together, and what an entry. Beautiful dive.
All eights with an 8.5, 67-20. Between dives, she's been reading a novel. We got this information from the pool deck, a novel on Kung Fu fighters. Here's Michelle Mitchell of the United States. She is in the lead. And this is the father. This is Mitch, the father with a lucky hat.
And this is Michelle's arm stand forward double somersault pike at 2.4. In the Olympic Games in 84, she balked on this dive.
Now that's with the foot coming down and hitting the platform again. It's automatic deduction of 2 points, and if you hit it twice, then it's a failed dive. And she struggled a bit on her arm stand in the preliminaries.
She held it fine.
Yes.
And that lineup was fine. That was a good dive. I'm glad she got by it. And she can sigh because she never has to do it again.
Again, that's right. She's retiring after this competition, after the next 3 dives.
Look at this. See how she holds that arm stand and then bends at the waist to get that little kip into the somersault. There's a nice lineup. The dive should score 7, 7.5. Could have been just a little cleaner.
Now tell me the truth, were you holding your breath on the arm stand?
Yes.
I think all of America
yes,
was.
Yes, I think everyone in the stadium was.
Yes. Yes. 53-28 for Michelle Mitchell. Xin Xiaodan of China is the 12th diver. The 12 divers selected after the preliminaries, and they are diving in the reverse order of their score in the preliminaries. So Xin Xiaodan, highest score in the preliminaries, but those scores all thrown out starting fresh today.
And watch this, forward 3 1/2 pike. And what a surprise. That was not the Chinese entry, the one that we've seen so many Chinese rip their dives, and that was very heavy, too much splash, and that is going to hurt her. She gets to the end of the platform well, throws into that nice tight pike position, but she comes out early, lifting her upper body and leaving the dive short of vertical, and that's where the splash comes from.
She is currently, prior to this score, in fourth place, a total here of 60-30. And we now have five rounds complete, and we will take a look at the standings. And she is also looking at the standings, and it is Xu Yanmei, who is now in first. Michelle Mitchell of the United States is now in second. Angela Stasilevich of the Soviet Union is in third. Qin Xiaodan of China is in fourth. Wendy Lian Williams of the United States is in fifth. And Silke Abisch of East Germany is in sixth. Those are the top six, with Xu Yanmei in first, Michelle Mitchell again of the United States is in second, and Wendy Lian Williams, United States, is in fifth. And it's still very close between first and second, as you now can look at the places of 7 through 12. These are the games of the 24th Olympiad. We're back to Seoul, Korea in just a moment. Welcome back to the diving venue here at the Chamshill Indoor Swimming Pool. Through five rounds, Michelle Mitchell of the United States is in second place. She was in first place, and then she moved back to second place. So there she is with her coach, Ron O'Brien. So right now, let's spend a moment in time with Michelle Mitchell.
Diving, when you're spinning around in the air, you actually see things. You'll see cars going by, you'll hear doors closing, conversations going on.
Michelle Mitchell doesn't want to see the cars, doesn't want to hear the doors. So she spends several hours a week exercising her mind with an innovative video program.
What Vision Quest teaches you to do is focus in on one thing, which probably would be your dive, and to hold that focus through that 1.2 seconds until you hit the water. And it's amazing what can go through your mind in 1.2 seconds. Sometimes, you know, I can be in the air and I can be cussing to myself because I did something wrong. Sometimes you think, wow, I nailed it, and you do it. Sometimes you think, kick, you know, you can hear yourself screaming in your head.
Michelle Mitchell screamed just loud enough at the 1984 Olympics to win a surprising silver medal on the platform. It was a remarkable achievement for two reasons. One, it was her first major international competition. And two, Michelle has never been too thrilled about standing on the edge of a platform 33 feet above the pool.
I am a very fearful diver. I'm scared every time I go up there. But again, when you're sitting down at your dinner table at the end of the day and you've dived platform, it's a great feeling of accomplishment and triumph when you can get through that. I'm not one to have a lot of superstitions. I don't have a favorite suit. I don't have a favorite stance or a little phrase I say or a little handshake I do. And I've done that purposely because my sport is ever changing. Every platform is different. Every circumstance is different. So to get in that kind of habit, I think, would be a little bit dangerous. But really, when you're perched on the edge of the platform on your hands or on the balls of your toes, it's really just you. And, you know, you might believe in a higher spirit, but I don't think believing that you have the right suit on is going to make a big difference.
Michelle's diving career has been hampered by injuries. She's had surgery on both shoulders, and earlier this year, an ear infection kept her from qualifying for the U.S. national team. She's an underdog here in Seoul, but she's not worried. It was the same in 84.
On any given day, especially in diving, anything can happen. The girl that won yesterday could be fourth tomorrow, and the girl that was 35th yesterday could be third tomorrow. So it's one of those sports where it's, for women's platform in Seoul, South Korea, it's going to be 1 day, 1 hour, 8 dives. And if you wake up on the wrong side of the bed, there's nothing you can do, and if it's your day, it's your day.
And- And Michelle Mitchell's coach is Ron O'Brien. You're watching her here. She's having a great performance so far.
Yeah, she's doing real well. I'm pleased with where she is at this point. And after that arm stand dive, which is low degree of difficulty and a little touchy on the takeoff, I'm real pleased with where she is.
She always looks a little bit tentative up there, like she might come back down and balk.
Well, that can happen, but fortunately she's done both of hers successfully, so she doesn't have to contend with that anymore, and she's got real good dives left, so I think she'll finish well.
When she's diving like this, does she get better? Does she hold this momentum?
Well, I think from this point on, she should get better. She's got three great dives left. We'll just have to see what she does with them.
Are you thinking gold medal, or do you dare?
I'm not thinking anything except straight up and down three more times, and then we'll see where we are.
All right. Good luck to you and to her. Let's go back to Charlie.
Thank you, Greg Lewis. Right now, Michelle Mitchell is in second place, and as Ron O'Brien said, she does have the three dives to go. And they are the last three dives in her career. She's retiring after this competition. It's Angela Stasilevich of the Soviet Union. She has been diving well. She's in third place.
She has a back 1 1/2 somersault with 2 1/2 twists, 2.8, another dive that she can do exceptionally well. This is her coach, Tatiana Karakashans.
We're in the sixth round. She will score well.
She should score very well on that dive. The judges have been harsh on her throughout the diving because she jumps away from the platform. Watch how far back she jumps. She moves, leans back into that twisting somersault. She should be almost a half meter closer to the platform to really get higher scores. However, this entry is very good. We'll just have to see what the judges give it.
7.5, 6, 7.5, 7, 7.5. Total is 60-48. Angela Stasilevich. And you can tell from the applause in the background, Wendy Leanne Williams of the United States is the next diver. And it's been kind of an up and down day. This is Charlie Jones, along with Steve McFarland. Steve, of course, a former Olympic coach, a former diver, and a former judge. So you cover all bases.
And this is a critical dive, a back 2 1/2 somersault pike at 2.9. If it's going to be here, this will tell the story.
Now, she can get in the top three if she can hit 7.5 or 8 here.
That's right. I would be surprised if that goes that high. It was a solid dive. It wasn't a dynamic dive. She needs dynamic dives right now. The jump is excellent. I love the way she gets into that tight pike. The come out is just fine, but she goes slightly beyond, straight up and down with a slight loose back. There's her sister. There's her coach. And you know they like it.
And her score, 7, 6.5, 7, total of 58-29. Again, you threw out the high and the low. Add up the other five times the degree of difficulty, times 60%, so you can match that up if you only have five judges in a contest. Here's Xu Yanmei of China.
And this is a forward 3 1/2 somersault pike at 3.0.
Leading after five rounds. And there's a towel on the platform.
She has been spooked, and that's the word, by the surface on this platform. She has put this towel down, and we'll see it on the replay. And because of this towel, she doesn't want to slip off the towel. She puts her towel down, but she doesn't get to the end of the platform when she jumps. Let's see if she does it here. She's about a foot to a foot and a half behind the end of the platform, and that is hurting her takeoff.
The good news is it is the official Olympic Games towel.
That's
all
right.
Sevens, but a 7.5 for a 63 total. Now here's Michelle Mitchell. Her sixth dive, 6 out of 8. 3 to go, including this.
And this is the inward 2 1/2 somersault pike at 2.8. Some of you may remember that she replaced her inward 3 1/2 somersault with this dive, and it's really made a difference in her performance.
She needs 8.5, maybe 9s here.
Very possible here, too.
She's in second place. It'll be close.
It will be close.
But close enough?
If I was judging that, I would give that an 8. Solid dive. Watch this. Right into the somersault. Nice tight pike. My only criticism, and it's a very picky one, is that she didn't get completely straight on that lineup. See, our body is slightly bent on the entry. And
her
here
on the
is
left
her
or coach on the right.
He's going to swallow that paper. He's so happy. And, of course, her father wearing the lucky hat. He wore that hat in the 84 games, and he wore it again in her Olympic trials.
Her score is 7.5 and 8, 64-68. I don't believe that's going to be good enough to take over first, but let's see what Chin Chow Don does here. She is the last diver in this round.
She's doing the inward 3 1/2 somersault tuck, a 3.2 degree of difficulty. And this is an unusual takeoff. We've been looking at this. If you watch her feet, you're going to see something that, as a coach, I would not recommend any diver doing. Watch this. Did you see that? Did you see that jump back onto the platform?
Yes.
Not only is that a fault, it is also dangerous and clearly affected this dive. She literally jumps back into the platform. She has a beautiful tight tuck and she spins very fast, but that little hop that she starts gives her a little too much over rotation, and that's going to hurt her in the scores.
In fourth place coming into this round, and low scores, 5.5, 5.6, total of 51-84. And so after six rounds are complete, Xu Yanmei of China is the leader. Michelle Mitchell of the United States remains in second place. Angela Sasilevich of the Soviet Union is in third. Wendy Lian Williams of the United States is in fourth. Chin Chow Don of China is in fifth. And Silke Abisch of East Germany is in sixth. And it stays close. There's only 9 points difference between first and second as you look now at places 7 through 12. We're going for the gold, the silver, and the bronze. We'll be back to the Olympics in a moment. We're back at the diving venue, Chamshill Indoor Swimming Pool. This is the final, the women's 10-meter platform. We are in the 7th of 8 rounds. Xu Yanmei of China is leading. After the 6th round, Michelle Mitchell of the United States is in 2nd. Angela Stasilevich of the Soviet Union is in 3rd, with Wendy Lian Williams of the United States next up on the platform in 4th place.
And this is a reverse 2 1/2 somersault. Her coach is very concerned. This is a big dive. She must do it well.
She is within striking distance of a medal. She needs to hit 7.5s or 8s here.
And she can do it. This can be a tremendous dive, or it can be a very risky dive.
In between.
In between. And that's kind of how she's been diving. She hasn't been so dramatic on her entries as she can be, as we've seen her do in the past. And it's too bad, because in this type of contest, that sort of dramatic finish will go a long way. What a beautiful jump. Nice tight tuck. Look at that tight tuck. The judges love that. The kick out is fine, but she reaches beyond. See her arms reach beyond, straight up and down, and the dive goes slightly over, and there's the splash.
6.5, 6, 6.5, 7, total of 51-03. She's been close. Xu Yanmei. Xu Yanmei leading the competition with 2 dives to go.
Now this is a reverse 2 1/2 somersault tuck. We will get a nice comparison on this dive and Wendy's dive. Everyone at home, try to see where her feet are when she kicks out of this tuck. It's very interesting.
There. Little low.
She kicks almost straight down at the water. And then maintains a nice straight body, and boy, what a rip. If I was judging that, I would go at least 9s on that dive. This panel has been a little stingy, so we'll have to wait and see what they do. Okay, here again we get to see it in slow motion, the judges' profile view. I see the legs come apart slightly. I don't know if the judges would have caught that, but here's that Chinese kick out. Straight body all the way to that rip entry.
And the judges say there's a 9, 8.5, 7.5, 68.04, and that is the leader. He's going to be tough to catch. Michelle Mitchell of the United States. She is in second place. But if she can hit 8, 8.5.
Well, here it is.
This she can take over first place.
This is her most difficult dive. And here's her father. He knows how important this dive is. This is the back 1.5 somersault with 3.5 twists, a 3.2 degree of difficulty.
If she hits it here, she could win the gold medal.
Position, and here is this lineup. Very, very nice, firm dive. If I was judging, I would definitely give it 8.
The judges agree. There's an 8.5 and a 9 to go with 8s and a pair of 7.5. 76.80. That's not going to be enough. Not quite enough. But she stays close. She stays close. It'll come down to the last two dives. Jin Xiaodan of China. Last diver in the next to last round.
Chen Xiaodan is doing the reverse 1.5 somersault with 3.5 twists, Charlie. The degree of difficulty on this is 3.3. This is the most difficult dive of anyone in the contest, and she is the only woman doing this dive. If she hits one like that, look out, because she's right back in the thick of things. Now let's see from this low angle. She reaches right up into the somersault, wraps that twist. Her feet are slightly crossed and a little loose. That's a deduction, but she gets them back together very well, and what a dramatic finish.
And the only female to do this dive in competition.
Absolutely. It's remarkable. The girl's only 14 years old, and Greg Louganis just learned that dive about 4 years ago.
Chen Xiaodan, she is 14 years of age, waiting on the score. Stands 4 feet 9 inches tall, weighs 83 pounds, in the vanguard of the youth movement.
And there is a youth movement in diving. We're seeing Elena Moroshina, and we're seeing right now the referee contacting the judges to re-enter the score. Occasionally, there are some malfunctions in the judging scoring method using the computers, so they must re-enter, and you see him pointing to judge number 6.
Well, let's see what we've got so far.
Eight and a half, nine, seven and a half, a nine, and an eight. Those are very good scores.
Those are excellent scores. And again, the degree of difficulty is 3.3. That's a total of 81.18. And you're right, you can get it back in one dive when your degree of difficulty is that high. So we now have 7 rounds completed. And you can see the results of that last dive. Xu Yanmei of China remains in first place. Michelle Mitchell of the United States is in second. And look how close that is. 27 hundredths of a point. Then Chen Xiaodan, who you just saw, has moved into third place, and everybody else in slides down, and we have one dive to go.
And that's the way it should be. The Olympic Games, it should come down to the last dive, and we have a real horse race here.
And a look at places 7 through 12, with 12 women in the finals here of the women's 10-meter platform with one round to go. Now, let's spend a moment in time with Xu Yanmei.
Bye, bye, bye. These little swimmers, like many other tiny athletes in the People's Republic of China, are being closely watched. They are being tested to see who among them might one day bring glory to the nation, not in the form of ideological zeal, but in the form of a gold medal. Most will not be chosen, but a select few will stay afloat, moving gradually up the hierarchy of the Chinese sports school system. Then the very elite will become world champions. Xu Yanmei, world champion platform diver, is among the elite. She's a typical product of the Chinese diving program, in which divers are chosen at a very young age not for their ability to dive, but for their body type, flexibility, personality, and capacity for hard work. Xu is aware that she's one of the lucky ones.
Diving is a lot of fun, and less lucky children can't have it. Besides, winning competition makes me happy.
Xu lives and trains with the national team in the city of Jinan, capital of the Shandong province. Like all Chinese champion athletes, Xu, in training, leads a rigorous and austere life. She and her teammates dive 6 hours a day and must be in bed at 9. They are not allowed to have telephones or televisions, and dating is prohibited. At birth, Xu was blessed with the makings of a great diver. She was also blessed with a very auspicious name.
My father, a teacher, has a plum tree growing outside his study, which blossoms beautifully. So he named me after the plum blossom, Mao's favorite flower.
Xu is at home in Jinan, a city of beautiful flowers. Here, the lotus blossoms cover the spring-fed lakes, which contain some of the purest water in all the world. The people of Jinan come to the springs to relax, reflect, and spend time with their families away from China's crowded city streets. It's fitting that this city, which harbors such natural beauty, is also a reservoir for so much natural talent. And just as the flowers are cultivated and nurtured, so too are China's best.
Xu Yanmei, she is leading. There with her coach. She is leading Michelle Mitchell of the United States with one dive remaining by 27/100th of a second. Michelle Mitchell, an opportunity to medal. Now she has an opportunity for a gold medal. The Olympics continue. This is the final round of the women's 10-meter platform. We're at the Chamshul Indoor Swimming Pool, the diving venue. We were looking for Greg. Is that Greg looking?
Yeah,
there he
that's
is.
Greg.
Oh, he's visiting. Greg, don't leave now. Maybe he's just going to get a better seat.
I think he's probably going to join his teammates because this is really the crucial time.
Yes. I'm amazed when we look at him. We mentioned it in the preliminaries that he's 28 years old and he's going to look great at the temples.
Well,
the dives that he's very tough. We'll see him in the springboard. We'll also see him in the men's platform later in the competition. The men's springboard starts tomorrow here. Silke Abicht of East Germany.
And she's doing the forward 3 1/2 somersaults pike, a degree of difficulty of 3.0. She's been a little inconsistent in her dives recently.
And there's that towel. We've seen that with a couple divers. The towel on the platform, some complaints about the platform being slippery. And again, like before, she ends up taking off a foot from the end of the platform. That is to change everything you do.
It certainly does. Instead of spinning up close, you wind up spinning away from the platform. So when you get out of the dive, your forward momentum carries you right beyond vertical.
The question is, why didn't they do something about the surface of the platform?
Well, they have. They've scrubbed the platform down. They've cleaned it up. And the tough divers say, it's not going to bother me. The ones that put the towel down, they're making a point of reminding themselves, this is a slick tower.
Does that give you an excuse to fail?
Yes, it does.
Now here's Elena Miroshina, her last dive, and she, your pick, I must bring that up, and she is in six, has not shown the sparkle that we thought that she would have.
And I am surprised,
yeah, I am
and
too.
I am humbled as well. This is a back 1 1/2 somersault, 3 1/2 twist, 3-2.
14 years of age. 4'9", 75 pounds. It's still not there.
It's just not there. And I saw her earlier in the week training and just diving up a storm. And I'm surprised that she didn't do better.
Remember the profile that we saw of Michelle Mitchell? She said, some days you wake up and it's just not there. I think that that happened.
Very true. Very true. Now, what was wrong with this dive? Not enough somersaults. She needs to rotate that somersault more on the start in order to make the dive finish straight on the bottom. And you can see her legs just do not get up fast enough, and that dive is considerably short of straight up and down.
Her score is low, fives, five and a half, there's a four and a half, 48.96, so it has been a disappointing Olympic Games for Lena Morochino. Angela Stasilevich of the Soviet Union.
Now she's doing a forward three and one half somersault tuck.
She is in fourth place, and I don't think is going to move up with that entry.
I don't think so either. It's an unusual entry. She doesn't get all of the way out of the tuck position. And the degree of difficulty on this dive at 2.7, compared to the other competitors, you really have to do a good dive here to stay in the contest.
And here is Wendy Lian Williams. She is now in fifth place. This is her last dive. And this is a dive that she got 10s on in the U.S. Nationals. She got 8s in the preliminary. Now, if she hits it, and she's really going to have to hit it well, she could pick up a medal. The possibility is there.
She has not been diving on. She's been slightly off on her dives throughout the contest. She needs to reach deep down at this point and pull out that best inward two and a half pike.
Can you do it in a series? Can you pull out just one dive?
It can be done, and we always admire the athletes who can under these circumstances. She went after the dive, she had good control, she lined the dive up and disappeared. Now watch this. Notice how close to the platform she is with her feet. Right here, that's acceptable distance. Beautiful, tight, tight. She looks like an envelope there, she's so tight. And here is this lineup and that beautiful rip entry. I would expect high scores. Oh, her sister loved it, and there's that sign.
The sign that they made them take down, but she's got it in again.
Well, it worked.
Eight and a half, seven and a half, eights across, 67-20. And we'll just have to wait to see how the scores total out with three divers remaining.
And there she is with her coach, Scott Rich.
Now, the way the diving order has worked, Xu Yanmei, who is leading, diving before Michelle Mitchell, so we'll know exactly what Michelle needs.
And this is a back two and one half somersault pike at 2.9. If there's any weakness in her list, it's right here.
She has been inconsistent with this dive.
That's going to be difficult to score.
Why?
The dive went in perfectly clean, hardly a ripple, but the dive did not go in straight. It went beyond vertical. Now let's watch this come out again that we saw in her reverse. Watch where her feet are in relation to the water when she lets go of that pike. Right there, pointing straight down. She lines up for the water, but reaches slightly beyond straight up and down. Now, I saw a slight turn there. I don't know if the judges would have picked that up.
8, 7.5, 8, 7, 8, 68-73.
The door is open.
Michelle Mitchell of the United States. Her final dive in competition. She retires after this dive.
And what a dive to retire on. It's her best one. Forward three and one half somersault tuck, 2.7.
She needs 8.5, 9s, points needed, 69 points for the gold. Will she have to settle for the silver?
She may. That dive was too short of vertical. I would expect lower scores than the one she needed. Again, you saw she was slightly back on the platform, and that dive did not go in straight up and down and without the splash that the judges like to see. See that? that's going to hurt her.
8, 7, 7.5. That's not enough. 60-75. That's not enough for the gold. She is still in the middle of the medals with one diver to go. That is Chin Xiaodan.
And what a dive this is going to be. A back 3.5 somersault tuck, a 3.3 degree of difficulty. And there is Su Yanmei and her coach, and they're eagerly waiting this dive.
If she hits it, possibility of a gold. If she hits it reasonably well, possibility of silver. Oh, no.
Oh. Looking at that jump back onto the platform, we saw her do it on her inward 3.5, and we're going to see it again here. And that is why she missed that dive. What a shame.
Oh, you don't want to finish that way. No.
See that jump back into the tower? The rotation is just too fast. She kicks straight up and down and way, way over.
But what this may do when you see the scores, and look how low the scores are, this may move Wendy Lian Williams to the bronze.
Oh, what a tremendous opportunity for Lian Williams, because that happens to be the nature of diving at this level.
We are double checking. It is Su Yanmei for the gold, Michelle Mitchell for the silver, and Wendy Lee Williams for the bronze. United States with their first two Olympic medals, and this is an upset.
A major upset.
Yes.
I think the U.S. coaching staff is stunned by this.
Let's go down to Greg Lewis. Greg?
All right, we're going to try to move out here, Charlie, so you can see our silver medalist. Well, what did you think about this day? You were in contention for a gold at one point.
I felt really good up there, like somebody was watching over me. And I'm really happy.
Silver in 84, silver in 88 is okay with you to finish the career?
Any medal is great with me to finish this career. I'm really pleased. And I'm really happy Wendy got in there, too.
What do you think made the difference today? It was within your grab till the very last there.
I think today was the experience of age versus the resiliency of youth. And I was hoping that experience would pay off, and it did for me. Silver's great.
Now what? No more diving at all? We don't get to see this beautiful performer anymore?
I think I might go up and do one more 3.5 for tens and see what happens. But no, I think this is it.
America's enjoyed you as a champion. Great job here today. Let's go back to Charlie.
Thank you, Greg. Yes, and our congratulations also to Michelle Mitchell, to Su Yanmei of China with the gold medal, Michelle Mitchell of the United States with the silver, Wendy Lian Williams with the bronze. And here is your gold medalist, Su Yanmei of China. The gold medalist, and deservedly so.
She really did, Charlie.
She hit
back and reverse optionals very well. She was steady all the way through the compulsory rounds, and she certainly does deserve the gold, and we're very happy to see that happen for her.
The results are now official here at the women's platform, 10-meter platform, the gold to China, the silver to the United States, and the bronze to the United States. Let's go to Brian. Thank you, Brian. And it was expected, well, it was a possibility, let's put it that way, to be the reality of it. Michelle Mitchell had a possibility of going for the medal. She has the silver. Wendy Lian Williams, we didn't think that she had that kind of a possibility, but she did. Su Yanmei of China, she's the gold medalist, and deservedly so. She was really diving well, and now she's being announced to the crowd here.
People's Republic of China.
The youngest of four children. Her name, Yanmei, means fresh flower.
The silver medalist, Michelle Mitchell, the United States of America.
And she now has two. One in Los Angeles in 1984, and there's her father, Mitch, with a lucky cap on. And the silver in 88. What a way to end a career. This is her last competition.
The bronze medalist, Wendy Lian Williams, the United States of America.
And this is a surprise. A little tentative at the beginning of today. But then when she got to the last three or four dives, she got better and better and better. And it takes eight dives. Eight dives to make the medal. And she did. Oh, what a moment.
관중 여러분, 중화인민공화국의 국가가 연주되겠습니다.
I think every photographer in the world always says, one more, just one more. And what a special moment.
Please stand for the playing of the national anthem of the People's Republic of China.
This one you remember in your memory book the rest of your life. Shu Yanmei, gold medalist.
This concludes our Olympic victory ceremony. Thank you.
지금까지 오늘 경기를 관람하여 주신 관중 여러분께 감사드립니다. 내일 경기를 안내해드리겠습니다. 내일 경기는 남자 스프링보드 다이빙 예선 경기로 오전 10시와 오후 2시에 시작됩니다. 관중 여러분께서는 경기 시작 1시간 전까지 입장하여 주시기 바랍니다.
Thank you for watching the competition, and we'd like to inform you that the men's springboard preliminaries will begin at 11.
Now let's go back
tomorrow.
To Bryant Gumbel.